Michael Talbot. Michael Talbot. I've been thinking a lot about Michael Talbot lately because I've been rereading one of his novels, which is one of my very favorite vampire novels. And today, from Amazon.com, I got a book. I used to own this book, but I just reordered it because I can't find my old copy. Mysticism and the New Physics by Michael Talbot. I corresponded briefly with Michael. Back in, what year was that? I had just read his novel, The Delicate Dependency. It's the best vampire novel ever written. And I wrote Michael a fan letter, something I love doing when I, so this is, I think it's 1982 that I got a reply from Michael, and I opened it on the side because I didn't want to break the seal, which is an Egyptian pharaoh kind of thing. A lovely response from Michael. The letter now is very badly water stained. But I'll just read a portion of it. My dear Mr. Pugmire, I have received your letter and just wanted to write you and thank you for taking the time to express your thoughts. No, I am not a misanthrope, but you are right. I do understand the feeling of being an outcast, although perhaps for reasons you might not suspect. I seem to have always had a mind interested in things that few other people are interested in. Part of my quirky curiosity led me to write my first book, Mysticism and the New Physics. It is, if you happen to take a look at it, an esoteric work, but I forge ahead undaunted. I decided to turn to fiction because I wanted to continue conveying all the bizarre things I find swirling in my head, but I also wanted to reach a larger audience. The result was The Delicate Dependency. So, he goes on, and, as you can see, the letter is very, very water stained. I don't know how that happened, but yeah, had a nice little image on it. It's so I reviewed The Delicate Dependency in my punk rock fanzine, Punk Lust, back in the early 80s, and I love that novel so much. I used to read it once a year, every year, and because it's more than just a vampire novel. It is it is brilliant. It is imaginative, original. The writing is superb. Michael was such a superb writer. And Ashley, look, I'm wearing my Dracula. Dracula! Speaking of vampires. Blood! The blood is the life! The blood is the life! That is a gift from my autumn sister, Ashley Talbot. In that letter, Michael says that he relates to being an outcast, but for reasons I might not suspect. I think he later died. He died at age 38 of leukemia, a blood disease, which makes the reading of this novel now very poignant to me. And I thought that when he said in that letter that he relates to being an outcast, that he was referring to his illness, his leukemia. But I just found out today that Michael Talbot was gay. He was a gay brother. I had no idea. So maybe that is what he's referring to. I don't know if I ever expressed to him that I was gay in our brief correspondence. I think he only wrote to me twice. That one letter, and then what I use as a bookmark for Delicate Dependency, he sent me a little card on this and wrote me a little letter thanking me for the review that I wrote in Punk Lust. But I am not a big fan of vampire novels because I'm just not into the vampire genre as it is portrayed by commercial horror fiction. And that's why The Delicate Dependency so stands out. It's set in kind of the bohemian world of either late Victorian, I think it's late Victorian because they mention, or early Edwardian, because in the novel they mention an early production of Wilde's Salome, I believe. I haven't read the novel for many, many years, and I'm rereading it now, and I just lost my place because I took out my bookmark. But I'm just, this new reading of it, it's like all good books, you know, if when you read it as a young man, as a young woman, you love it because it is so brilliant. It is like nothing else. It is a magnificent work of fiction. The portrayal of the vampires is hypnotic. It's just wonderful. But then the more, when you return to it as a mature reader, it takes on a new resonance. And because it is a brilliant book, every time you return to it, you find things in the novel that you didn't appreciate when you were a child, a wee child. And now, as an old man, I see things in this magnificent novel that I wasn't able to appreciate when I was a child. So I love this novel by Michael Talbot, and I'm so astonished. I found out just today that he is my gay brother. May he rest in peace. I've read one of his other horror novels, The Bog, which I did not like. It was generic. It was set in suburbia, American suburbia. It was so divorced from everything that makes The Delicate Dependency a wonderful and original work. But perhaps I shall have